Now we move to the second part of the extensibility story, where you could actually train a custom pre-built invoice processing model, pass it on several documents as a collection, add an additional field which is present on the document, tag it, publish it. So that's the second step we are going to showcase. To build a custom model which can actually help you recognize additional fields on an invoice, you would need to go to the Maker's portal, go on AI Hub, and then click on see more AI models and select invoice processing model, that is, which is saying prebuilt. Once you select this, and then you say use prebuilt model and then create custom model, then you'll be able to create a model which can be utilized on invoice capture as a custom prebuilt model. So I have created one already. I'm going to open that. First step is choose the document type and then choose the information to extract. In this choose information to extract, you would want to add an additional field that you want to extract here. So you can say add text field and give it a name. So please also save this name separately. So once you have added this field, you would need to add a collection of documents which contains this field. So I have already given a collection of 6 documents where I've added the MSME number here. So if you see, I've added MSME number here and the other place it's MSME 4. So this would be my label. I'll be tagging this particular value from the document to the field that I'm going to tap. Once you have added the collection, the next step would actually take you to tagging the documents. So if I go to tagging the documents section, so I have successfully tagged this field to MSME. Similarly, for all the other invoices that I've actually uploaded in the collection. Just a quick tip, I just use the same document across. For you, since it's a business case, you would want to train with all the different types of document that your vendors are sending your customer, your implementing customer, right? So once this is done, you would just process it, say next, and then it will finish off training the model. Once this is done, you would just click on train. Since there's nothing more added from my side, it would finalize it very soon. And then once it is done, you should be able to publish this. So you go to the details page. And then once the training is done, it will show you the model details. We can actually just say publish this. Since the training is still going on, it won't allow me to publish. Just wait for a minute. It got published. So click this button, it will get published. So I have already published my version of the training model. So I'm not going to do it right now. This completes our second video where we talk about training the custom AI builder model.